excited to have Steve Ventil join me today, the CEO of Brivo.
A little bit of background on Brivo for people who may not know us. We're the world's first and largest cloud-based access control system. We first launched into this market in 2001. Today, we've got over 20 million credential users on the system. We're active in 42 different countries, and we've got a dealer channel base of about 1,500 right now.
If you can give a little bit of background as far as what Brivo is doing with data, and then share some information about the views of how you see it's going to go.
Sure. Obviously, we've been collecting data now for 20 years, and our run rate today on data acquisition is about 10 to 20 million door events per day. So that gives you a sense of the amount of information collecting. We also collect a lot of sensor data, and we've got a very big stream of video analytics events that come into the system. But most of my remarks today are going to be about the door information, because that's become more interesting in the COVID crisis, because it reflects a change in the number of people who are going into commercial property. A few years ago, we started thinking a little bit more about what kind of analytics we can do on top of that data. So we built some extensions to our existing data infrastructure that were more conducive to doing analytics. So we've got a lot of things that are over in S3. We're using Snowflake on top of that. We're using another analytical tool called Periscope on top of that. And then we've got a lot of custom analytics. So we've got essentially a library of different tools that we can use to get at the data and express it in different ways. And so right now that's going to show up first in new enterprise edition of Brivo's flagship product that's going to have a lot of those capabilities in there. But there's also a lot of value in other domains to this information. So people have obviously been looking to access control information for many years for things like energy management, occupancy information, things like that. What we realized was that with the COVID situation that we've got right now, there was actually a societal value to a lot of the information that we're collecting. And people are very interested in knowing where people are actively following stay-at-home orders. They're interested in how much different industries are changing compared to one another. They're interested in which states are more affected, when were they affected. And because our data is actually international, we can do those comparisons between places here in the US as well as international locations. So we've got a very global view, actually, of how the COVID virus crisis is affecting the usage of commercial buildings.
It feels like it's access control with this. It's having somewhat of a moment, whether it's on the touchless side of the people talking about, and now also just the data of understanding and sort of around the whole concept around value creation that goes beyond just the security side of what we do.
I think value creation is really important part of what's happening right now. So when we started, if you could open a door and tell somebody that the door had opened, that was kind of all that was expected of access control. And as we've moved from our original base of serving small and mid-sized business to having lots of enterprise clients, the demands on how that data is visualized, how that data is analyzed, what the retention policies were around that have only grown as those larger customers have taken on the cloud as a way of dealing with access control, just like they've taken on cloud as a way of dealing with everything else from CRM to finance to pretty much any corporate function you can think of, to the point where now we have over 200 Fortune 500 customers on the platform. And we're seeing lots of new requests for data, which we can then build back into this platform.
Yeah, I guess the other thing that just as you're saying that, it triggered me to think about is the ability to pull all that data as quickly as you were able to and analyze it how quickly you're able to, or value that having cloud-based systems gives you that ability to pull that data. So
it is. One of the experiences I had earlier in my career before I started Brivo was in the healthcare information field. And I worked for a company that digested all kinds of information about hospitals, clinics, things of that, illness severity, and so forth. And the nature of the business was to transform that data into reports and benchmarks and the like that different customers would find of interest or of use in how they run their healthcare institution based on what the norms and the benchmarks were. And so it's always been my dream with Brivo that we would one day graduate not only into a platform that could do that kind of benchmarking and provide data as a product, but that we would graduate into the kinds of customers that want and need that kind of information. So small businesses, probably not that interested in that sort of thing. They're running their dry cleaners, or they're running their pizza shop or their bar, whatever it happens to be, and they don't really have much need for that kind of information. Once you get into these larger organizations that are interested in things like compliance, they're interested in comparison to how other people in their vertical might be doing. Now you've got an audience for this kind of information that we didn't have, let's say, 10 years ago. We started looking at what's going on right now with the pandemic as a more or less geographic crisis. So one of the first visualizations we did was based on a map, because that's the obvious way to represent geographic information. And so what we did was we started off and looked at 30 days prior to the onset of the pandemic. So you can think of that as more or less the February timeframe. It starts out showing a set of colors that represent more or less the average level of business activity in the US on a state-by-state basis. When you run that fast forward, what you're going to see is the country is becoming increasingly red. And the deeper the red is, the deeper the drop in economic activity in commercial office buildings. So we computed average usage of commercial buildings over that period for each individual state. So we had a very solid baseline that was comprised of hundreds of millions or even billions, I'm not quite sure, of data points on what's the typical behavior across the spectrum of customers that we have. Then we started tracking, roughly starting at the beginning of March, what was happening as different events in the news came to pass. So when March 12th, we started to see states go dark. When we heard more and more states and more cities issuing stay-at-home orders, we saw that those states and those cities were going dark, to the point where if you look at something like New York City, which is obviously at the top of the list right now in terms of infection, we've seen an 80% decrease in the usage of commercial office spaces and other businesses in New York. And that's just phenomenal. You see the same sort of thing in different industries too. I think we're all aware that our health clubs have shut down. Mine has. They sent a nice email saying that I didn't have to pay for it while they were shutting down. So I appreciate that. But we saw them and we took a look at them. They're down 90%. There must be a few people sneaking in and using these things. But the fact that it was above zero was kind of interesting. And then, if you look at some other industries, it tells a different story. So if you look at agriculture, for example, they're only down about 50%. Why? Well, obviously, agriculture is an essential service. People have to go in and produce the food that we're all eating. Regardless of the pandemic, they seem to be able to do it with fewer employees than they used to on average, but they're still not dropping like other industries or other geographies. We're all wondering how deep the dip is going to be and how long that dip is going to be. Is it a single V? Is it a double V? And of course, we're all interested in that from an economic point of view, but I think that office occupancy and office utilization is actually going to be a leading indicator for the return of the economic activity, because people are going to start coming back into work. They're not going to necessarily change their sales volume or anything else that's a business metric on their first day back in the office, but they are going to start building up more of a customer backlog. If they're producing physical goods, then they're manufacturing more of those. And we're going to see that long before we see the economic bounce back. So I think this is going to be a very interesting predictor of future economic change. And so to that end, we've been putting together a website where people can come and see not only the current data, but they can see as that data comes in real time, that economic bounce back that we're all anxiously awaiting. Yeah.
Well, thank you, Steve. I really appreciate you making the time. This is very exciting. It's nice to see highlights of opportunity that come out of what's really a crisis, and nobody wants to be going through this. But through all of them, I think over time we've seen there's been innovation and things have changed. And in the end, hopefully, outside of the catastrophes that happen, things become better. So thank you for sharing what you and your team are doing, and excited to see what happens with it next.